Everybody wants a retain, but nobody wants to put in the work. What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel, and this is my channel where I talk about all things reef tank related. But in this video, we're gonna be going over the top 5 corals for beginners, because I've been noticing a lot of new reefers in the hobby, and I plan on helping these guys out with their first coral. So let's get it. So in no particular order, the first coral on the list would have to be the Duncan coral. Hey, the Duncan coral is a nice coral to have in your tank. It's also a first responder, which in my case, first responder means that it'll be the first sign of distress in your tank. It's also a fast grower. Once you get feeding it, your clowns love them. Everything loves them in the tank. They're very peaceful. It is just a great beginner coral to have in your tank. Now, once you get your feet wet in this hobby, I want you to go out and try a hammer coral, or are you feeling a coral, which they call something else now. These corals can be very easy in your tank, as long as you stand on top of your water changes and make sure you replenish new elements that are missing from your tank over time. So these corals are very nice. They bring that little wavy motion to your tank, and you know they look very lively. So once you get it going, hey, I do recommend you go ahead and try a hammer coral. Try one at a time, see how the first hammer coral do in your tank. Once you got one hammer coral in the tank for a month or two, go ahead and pop it in 2, 3, 4, make a hammer garden if you can. Number 3 has to go to the mushroom coral. Hey, the mushroom coral, they can grow in about any environment in your tank. Well, they don't need too much light, so keep them at the bottom of your tank. But they can grow in pretty much anybody's tank is what I mean. They pretty much like dirty water. So this is a perfect coral for beginners because we're prone to making mistakes. Even I still make some mistakes till today. So go ahead and try some green, red, blue. They come in all different colors and sizes. Go ahead and try some mushroom corals as your beginner coral. Number 2 has to be one of my favorite corals of all time, and that's the zoanthids. Hey, these zoanthids, they come in all different colors. You can do all type of arrangements with, you know, the color scheme. And they also come in different sizes, which, you know, the bigger they are, that means they're really pallies. But I do have to precaution you about the zoanthids in the pallies. They carry a very dangerous venom called pallitoxin. They can kill a full-blown human. So I just want you to be careful when handling these guys and always wear your PPE. We don't know what PPE stands for. This personal protection equipment. So it is definitely is an all-time favorite for most reefers because they spread fast, and they can color up your scape a lot faster than most corals can. My clownfish love them. My clownfish actually hosts them every now and then, but he also hosts my Duncan. Very colorful coral and a very solid beginner coral. Now, before I get to my number 1, I just have to let you know, I didn't want to put green star polyp or waving hand, zinnia, or all that stuff on here. I wanted to do corals that I actually have experience with. I have experience with the green star polyp, but as far as a good beginner coral that I know won't take over your scape as fast, I would have to go with something totally different. So. Before I get you my number 1, I do have to recommend the RFAs, the rock flower anemones. If you want to go a totally different route and you want to do like a rock flower anemone tank, they're very colorful. They come in all different colors and sizes. They don't come with the headache that a coral can have sometimes, you know. They're very hardy. They can take a beating. And I just think they're pretty cool to have in your tank. They will eat sick fish, so if you have a fish in your tank that's a little sick, he ends up falling on it and he doesn't have the strength to swim away from that RFA, and RFA is going to eat that fish. So that's my only thing about them. But hey, if it's a fish sick anyway, I mean, it's better for it to become, you know, part of the ecosystem in the first place. So. But my number 1 coral has to go to the mushroom leather coral. They come in different colors. You got the green long tentacle, you got the white long tentacle, it's all different types of shapes and sizes of the mushroom leathers. One of the best mushroom leather corals out there would have to be the weeping willow, which I do not have. It's just a longer version of the mushroom leather coral that swings almost like an anemone. or a torch. If you don't know what a torch is, that's a torch. Yeah, but yeah, the mushroom leather, it can grow any in anybody's tank. I don't care if you're doing acro tank or you're doing a softy, all softy tank. The mushroom leather coral can grow in any tank, even with high nitrates and high phosphates. It will grow. It will be there forever. It might close up on you. Don't throw it away when it closes up. It does this from time to time because it's getting ready to shed that top layer of skin. And once it sheds that top layer of skin, it's actually gonna come out a little bigger than what it was at first. So, hey guys, that's to me one of the top beginner-friendly corals that you can put in your tank. Let's get it. Yo, so if you're enjoying this type of content, please let me know by liking and subscribing, because that's the only way I can tell if my viewers are enjoying this type of content or if I'm actually helping somebody out. Matter of fact, if I'm helping you out, make sure you share this video with your friends that's trying to get in the reefing hobby also. And if you haven't watched my last video where I talk about all the different corals in my tank, make sure you go back and watch it. I'll post it right here. Hey, you guys, keep reefing, and God bless. Let's get it.